Hello LEGO fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO City set from 2007. This one's called the Fire Hovercraft and it came with 274 pieces. Now I got this set used and opened off eBay, so like many things that you get from eBay, it was missing a few parts. I was able to replace those parts pretty easily because it's a fairly recent set and you know it doesn't have any really unusual parts other than the hull, if you will, kind of section to it. But what I wasn't able to replace was the set of stickers. You'll notice that there are no stickers on this, and there should be stickers. So I'm sorry about that, but hopefully you'll still be able to see enough of the detail of what this thing should look like here. So yeah, it's a fire hovercraft, which is awesome. I know when I was a kid, I was way into hovercrafts. I thought that they were really interesting and intriguing and thought they were the wave of the future. If you've not seen this set before, it is based around a single large piece, a single mold. This whole black thing is all one piece. Some wheels are attached on turntables underneath and they actually elevate the entire thing above the ground. Most of the attachments are done via just little Technic pin sized holes. You can actually attach some studs back here, but for the most part, stuff is just intended to be attached with pins, which is fine. It works out just fine. And it's not like the entire thing from the top is all that material, because all these plates get put into place and these large grill pieces that are underneath these engine areas and the lift fan areas. So it all becomes a pretty proper LEGO build. You know, oftentimes when LEGO has made stuff with really large pieces, I've actually not enjoyed the builds very much just because it just takes so much away. But with this one, they were able to preserve the building process because there are still a good number of parts, an appropriate number of parts, I feel, that went into the build of this thing in its assembly. So these are your thrust fans, which are going to be propelling the thing, making it go forward and back, and also helping it to turn via differential thrust. You spin one fan at a different rate compared to the other, and the thing will turn. These are the lift fans, so this is intended to be where air would be sucked in from above and then pushed underneath to lift the whole thing up. This is actually a plastic piece, so it's not in the most realistic form, but that's perfectly fine. It makes total sense to do it the way that they did. Kind of a matte finish on this also, which is a nice finish. It would not have looked so good. It would have been more toyish and plasticky looking, I think, if it was actually done in a more glossy finish. Some of the other features, well, first of all, you can see that I'm turning the little inlets up here, and those are actually connected to some of the wheels underneath. So you've got these wheels that can turn around, and if you get the right amount of traction on all of them, then hopefully they kind of work like casters and you should be able to, yeah, they kind of get the idea. You have to assemble this thing quite perfectly in order to get equal traction between all of the tires. Also, some of these parts are, you know, they've been used. Like I said, it's used and they've been played with, so they're not in perfect condition. A little bit of extra friction in there, but the general idea is that you can spin this thing any kind of way because it's supposed to be hovering on air, and as it spins around, these things should kind of move with you. On the front, at the very front, you've got this awesome little dual monitor turret where you can put a minifig in there and he gets to turn around like so. He can also change the elevation of the entire thing. It doesn't go up too high, but still it's good to be able to angle it and to spin it around. It really kind of looks like and works like, I'd say, you know, like a gun kind of turret. So that's a great way to get the shooting kind of action that a lot of kids want to be able to play with while still keeping it within a peaceful theme, because you're shooting water and you know you get to target things. That's great. And you got a little light on the front here. I like the use of this style of wheel. It's a small wheel that just fits onto a jumper piece right there, rather than using the more vehicular style. That was a really nice little touch. Got your little rings here you can throw overboard to help folks. And then on the sides, you also have these monitors, which can be representing remote monitors that are extra high powered, and you can use those. One on either side, there's the other one over there. That's a nice thing. These are supposed to be lights to help you see what you're shooting at if it's, you know, a little slightly dark conditions. But the way these are attached, I actually doubled up these little half thickness lift arms, these gray pieces back here. It's supposed to only have one on either side, and it just doesn't create enough friction in there to really hold these together. This one's actually holding in place a little bit better than the other one. The other one's just kind of falling down on the other side. But even with them doubled up, still didn't quite work out perfectly with the way that these came out of the mold. I don't know if that was the greatest choice right there. This section right here looks curious. It looks like it should be doing something. There should be a sticker on top of there, but the real important thing here, wrong side, is this. You've got this wheel. Oh, got this wheel here, which is able to open this up, and that's a nice little action there, and it gives you a little compartment. You can see some little tools in there. You can take those out, including a lamp, a little loudspeaker unit, and a set of binoculars, and there's also kind of a saw in there. So those are all things that your minifigs can use. This is very nicely concealed. Got a couple of fire extinguishers there also. And then as you move back farther, you get to the main control section, the whole cabin and cockpit area, which is also pretty nice because it has some nice detailing up above. You've got a little radar dish up here, nice little stock with a couple of antennae, and the lights that are pretty important for anything emergency related. This opens up this way, which is pretty good. Let's see if it goes one step farther. I think that might be it. There it goes. Okay, that's as far as it goes. And you got one single seat in there for your captain figure to be sitting there. And he's got a little console that actually has a sticker on it, which I believe was specific to this set. So I think that is the correct one that I actually got with that. I actually got lucky and got one sticker. It's interesting that they put this on one of these little flag style pieces rather than using a tile or something. But only one guy fits in there. That's, you know, that's just how it goes when you scale things like this. I think it looks so good that I'm really not gonna be able to complain at all about that size. Couple more spots for minifig accessories here with your walkie-talkie, an axe here, and another axe on the other side. Extra spot for one, and then again your lift, not your lift, your thrust motors and fans. And you can see them from the front, pretty nicely done. Really quick before I talk about these guys, I did try getting the hovercraft to float in water, and it kinda does, but it's not pretty, and it's definitely not designed to float at all. It will start to sink pretty quickly and easily. Three minifigures with this set. This is your captain figure, supposedly, and this is just a random crew member, and that's me, obviously, right? At this time, they were still coming with the extra large personal flotation devices, which were later changed to smaller ones. All of these have the same torso, so I'm not going to take the PFDs off the other two guys. They look exactly the same. I like the high visibility stripes on there. They actually have inside of the kind of greenish yellow there is metallic, and you can see just a little bit of my skin tone actually reflecting off of that because it has so much reflectiveness to it. No prints on the back of these, but at least you do get two different types of hats. That's kind of cool. Cool. So you know what I like about this set the most? It's different. It's something that LEGO hasn't done much of. You know, just the whole fire is not even fire hovercraft. Hovercraft in general is a type of vehicle that is not common. So I really appreciate that. I really appreciate that they stepped outside of the normal bounds of just normalcy and went to something unusual. I think it's really cool. I think that it's great to get something that is so versatile that can be used on water and on land, you know, in the imaginary sense only, of course. And they did manage to pull off a very believable design. This is something that could actually exist in real life. All of its features really make sense. So I'm very happy with it. Sorry that I wasn't able to show you the stickers since I didn't get them, but hopefully that didn't take too much away from the detail that you got from this review. As always, your comments are welcome. It's always good to see more feedback from more different people. If you'd like to see my reviews of other sets, new and old, be sure to check out some of the playlists on my channel. And if you want to stay on top of everything that I'm doing that's Lego related, including stuff that you'll never see on video, be sure to follow the blog at JANGBRiCKS.com. Hope to see you there, and I'll talk to you again soon.